I've talked a little bit about how here in New York at the subway station near the studio where I get off every day, there are more and more Jehovah's Witnesses that have set up shop and are handing out pamphlets. It used to be just one person, and eventually went to two people staffing that table. More recently, they've now set up two tables with two staffers at each, plus a fifth person who actually stands by the stairs handing out pamphlets. So they've gone from one to five people. I recently got a really interesting article from Sean McGuire about Anthony Morris III. Anthony Morris III is a member of the governing body of Jehovah's Witnesses, and he is absolutely obsessed with tight pants that he claims have been designed by gay people. He goes all over the world. This is a guy who speaks all over the world as a professional Jehovah's Witness, and he's obsessed with talking about tight pants that he believes were designed by gay men. Here's a little bit of audio. Let's get into this. This is one speech, sermon, I don't even know what to call it, that he gave earlier this year. Listen.
In America, and I know it's in Europe, here in Italy as well, they have what they call now the metrosexual look. It's becoming very popular. It's not new, but it's new that it's becoming so very popular. And what it means is that their suit, if they have a suit on, or their pants, extremely tight, all the way down to the ankles. Very, very tight. Now, you can see how Mauro and I are dressed. He's got a better physique than I do now. So it's not that you don't dress nice to fit your physique. That's fine. That's what Max and I do. What's wrong is this extremely tight pants. It's not appropriate for a Christian.
Okay, so there's that. And then just a few days ago, again, focusing in on the tight pants and saying God really doesn't like these tight pants. Listen to this.
Not in this organization. And frankly, I have asked sister after sister, you know, what do you think of this? Do you find that appealing, attractive? You know, I'm just curious, because I'm not a woman. And you know what? I've not had one yet that thought they look good. But like I've been telling others, and this is a fact, the homosexuals that are designing these clothes, they like you in tight pants.
So there it is. It's the homosexuals who design tight pants exclusively, and they really want you in those pants. And then here's the last one. This is just amazing. He mentioned that he was in Italy. I guess he did a bunch of things in Italy. And at one of these things, they had a translator. Listen to how funny it is to hear utter insanity about tight pants and gay people live translated to another language just to make sure that none of the Italians that are listening to Anthony Morris III miss a second of this. You will hear the translation happening as he speaks. Check this out.
So it's not that you don't dress nice to fit your physique. That's fine.
Non vogliamo dire che I vostri abiti non debbano adattarsi alla vostra figura. Non c'è nulla di male in questo.
That's what Max and I do.
Questo è quello che facciamo io e Max.
What's wrong is this extremely tight pants.
Quello che è sbagliato, quello che non va, sono questi pantaloni assolutamente attillati, aderenti.
It's not appropriate for a Christian.
Non è appropriato per un cristiano.
And I want you brothers to think about this.
E fratelli, vorrei che rifletteste su questo.
Do you remember that many, many, many homosexuals are in the clothing industry and doing the designing?
Sapete che ci sono molti omosessuali nel mondo della moda, nell'industria della moda, che si occupano di disegnare modelli.
Don't you know they love it when you're wearing tight pants?
Non sapete che quando indossate I pantaloni così attillati a loro fa un gran piacere?
Oh yeah, you chuckle. I don't think it's funny, I think it's disgusting.
Beh, sapete, io non penso che sia una cosa divertente, penso che sia una cosa disgustosa.
It's just amazing, Lewis. Anti-gay, anti-metrosexual, anti-tight pants preaching all over the world being translated in this particular case into Italian. It's incredible to me that Anthony Morris III thinks about men in tight pants so often. It would seem to me that this is not a high priority for most people, and he's just constantly talking about it.
It seems that he's a very high-ranking member of the Jehovah's, if there is such a ranking system. I don't know. He seems like he's a bigwig. Should hearing this make you no longer want to be a Jehovah's Witness if you are one? Or is this guy just kind of a nut who needs to go?
I have no idea. That's the thing. We've done some interviews with ex-Jehovah's Witnesses, and we've heard about a lot of the craziness that goes on. And this includes the cover-up of child abuse. This includes the feverent, to borrow Lewis's term, feverent proselytizing, so on and so forth. I didn't know that this was such a focus. In general, I didn't know that being anti-gay was such a focus of the Jehovah's Witnesses. I knew it was a part of it, of course. I didn't know it was such a focus. I'm not sure what rank or what prevalence this focus on tight pants designed by gay people has within the Jehovah's Witnesses. But what I know is I always think every day when I see the Jehovah's Witnesses waiting outside the subway, I think about going up to them and saying, what do you think about the cover-up of child abuse in your religion? And as the guest we interviewed, the ex Jehovah's Witnesses said to me, they just wouldn't know anything about it because they're probably only in a universe of sanitized, approved information. They honestly wouldn't even know what you're talking about, David.
Yeah, probably living in a vacuum, but at least we can tell them about this guy. And hopefully they watch the video and start to second guess things.
We've got a great program planned for you today. Make sure to follow me on Twitter, twitter.com/dpacman, and join us on Reddit, davidpacman.com/reddit. That's REDDIT.